We have already read some part of the story, A Little Frog in the Well. Today we are going to do the second part of the same story. We have already read that a little frog was living in a damp place in the well, and he refused to come out of the well. Different birds, they flew over there on the well and offered him to come out of the well, but he refused. Then a yellow sparrow came to him again and again and asked him to come out of the well, but he refused. The yellow sparrow came to the frog for many days, for 6 days continuously, but he refused to come out of the well. Then what happened on the seventh day? Finally, the yellow sparrow became angry. He flew down to the bottom of the well, picked up the little frog on his back and flew out of the well. So finally on seventh day, the yellow sparrow managed to pick the frog from the well, and ultimately the frog came out of the well. "Oh," the little frog exclaimed, how is it that the outside world is so big? He had been in the bottom of his dark well for so long that the bright sunshine made his eyes blink shut, and he could hardly open his eyes to see. When he finally opened his eyes, he saw so many things around him. "Hey, be careful. Don't hit this strange thing. What are these green, high and low things?" The yellow sparrow laughed happily. "Ha ha, these are mountains and valleys. There are countless mountains in this world. The Himalayas, the Swiss Alps, the Rockies, and so there are so many different mountains that are there in the world." But as the frog, he had been living for a very long time in the dark well, that he was not even aware of the high mountains in the world. The little frog could not believe there were so many big mountains in the world. When they flew over the high mountains, the next view made the little frog even more surprised. "What is this long, silvery, shiny view?" "It is a river," the yellow sparrow replied. "Then what is that huge blue thing over there?" "That is a sea," the yellow sparrow replied. "That river and sea, how much water do they have? How much bigger are they than my well?" "They must hold a billion times more water than my well." The little frog began to realize how tiny his well was. "Let's go down." "Okay." The yellow sparrow put the little frog down on the ground and flew away. Means ultimately, the frog came out of the well and enjoyed the beautiful world outside. He could see the high, tall mountains, trees, rivers, oceans, and ultimately the yellow sparrow flew away and put him down on the ground. The little frog jumped into the grass and saw many beautiful flowers of different colors. He had never seen such beautiful flowers and had never smelled such nice scents. He kept on going and went into a forest. In it, he looked up and saw many tall trees. He looked down and found many different kinds of fruits that had fallen to the ground. He picked up an apple and tasted it. "Wow, so sweet." Then he listened to the beautiful singing of the birds. The cute squirrels were jumping. The monkeys were swinging from branch to branch, and the antelopes were scampering speedily. In the pond, the lotus flowers were dancing in the air, and the lotus leaves were floating on the water like umbrellas. There were many fish in the water. "The outside world is so big, so wonderful, and so beautiful," the little frog finally cried out happily and jumped into the pond. He climbed up on a huge lotus leaf and enjoyed his new life there. The yellow sparrow came back and asked little frog, "How is this outside world big, beautiful?" So these words are very important: big and beautiful. The world is big, the world is beautiful. The only thing that we need is to understand this world. And the next thing is, thank you very much if you had not brought me out to see this world. I would never had known that there are such beautiful things that exist outside my well. The little frog never tried to go back to his old well again. So this is the end of the story, that ultimately the frog decided to live over there and to enjoy the beauties of nature, as the world is so big and so beautiful. Now read this story again and again. Try to speak the difficult words again and again. Try to improve your reading, because this is all about the reading skills. And try to understand the meanings of the story also, the moral that the writer wants to convey. Try to understand that moral also. And the important things is then underline the difficult words also and find out the meanings from the dictionary. Write them in your copies. So understand the story. And this is all for today's, I think. Thank you.